Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Planet Zoo and the continuation of our Amsterdam cryptid weirdo build thingamajiggy. So we're carrying on working on the wetlands pack. I say that today we're kind of building our own animals, as you'll see probably in the thumbnail actually. Next video will be the wild water buffalo, but this little section here already took such a monumental amount of time that I couldn't find the time to get the buffalo in as well. It would have been a humongous video. And at some point the videos get so long that the time lapse becomes irrelevant, because to fit it in I'd have to run on, like, you know, 2000% speed, and you're not actually going to be able to see what's going on. Much like you can't right now because it's the middle of the bloody night. That will be a consistent theme, I'm very sorry. I do need to give a shout out to two creators, the coral that you're seeing being used here. And of course the ship from a moment ago were both made by two people on the workshop. It's a creatist for the coral. I cannot remember the ship off the top of my head, but they will be credited a little bit later on in the video when we do our tour. They're listed on my board of skilled explorers. Anyways, a creatist made this wonderful coral. And as we went through last time, the whole point of this section here is really to make it feel like you've drowned. It's not the most optimistic section. I'm not going to tell the player that, so it's up to them to figure it out anyway. But you walk through this veil of water, and then suddenly there's this coral-laden, misty, blue, underwater feeling sort of thing with underwater plants hanging off. These are lotus plants hanging down from the ceiling, look really cool, I think. All this coral around, and then bringing in some of the Planet Zoo aquatic plants as well. And the idea is that the bark, B-A-A-K, not bark, 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 back, maybe it's back. Anyways, the back has dragged you, as it does in reality, well, in cryptid lore, it drags you down below the water and then eats you, kills you, and takes your form, basically. So the idea is that's what's happened to the player, and you're going to try to get out, essentially. Because that's what you would do in a zoo, obviously. Chester Zoo's my local. I've been many times, and many times I have been drowned by a vengeful ghost. Stop arguing with me. But as I said last time, it is important that it feels like a zoo. My current theory is that the animal exhibits themselves, because I've got a few ideas that are quite normal. The animal exhibits themselves might be relatively normal, and then I'll go super heavy on the theming and the cryptid areas, and that way we kind of get a nice balance of both. But even in this cryptid area, there's going to be like a normal pathway. I've built this little fence out of temple pieces and metal, and there's going to be vending machines and benches and all that kind of stuff. It's never meant to full-on feel like you're in that environment, other than the ice cave, which, you know, was a little over the top and I can't bother fixing it, basically. But other than the ice cave, it should never really feel like that. So this is very much a realism's not vibes, wait, all the way around, a vibes not realism sort of thing, in that there's water kind of moving around the ceiling, and in the next little bit there's water above you and below you. It's just go with it, you know, lose your mind a little bit, just be all wishy-washy. Very appropriate terms. There's water bloody everywhere, you're under the sea. That's all that matters, okay? I do need some stuff in this walkway. I'm not quite sure what yet. That's what am I doing? Oh, yeah, I'm making my own jellyfish. This is something we did a long, long time ago. People have been doing this in Planet Zoo for absolutely ages. It is just one of those circular shapes. Cut in half, an obloid cut in half, and then you stick some vines on the back. And look at my dedication to realism here. They're even hanging from sticks to the ceiling, just so they're not just randomly floating, as they will be in the next section. But yeah, I really like how those jellyfish, I've always really liked how those jellyfish look. I think they're very effective. I apologize that it's so hard to see, but I had to build at night time to know what I was doing. So anyways, that's that bit done initially. That's our walkthrough underwater path, and now we're going to do basically the same thing here, but this is going to be much more of a large, this is the area of the bark. This is the back. This is the big, the set piece for the cryptid, shall we say. The big thing we're going to be working on for the rest of the video. And we're going to do some cool stuff in here. So, okay, that. This took so long to fix this bloody path. The paths are super annoying because they don't go back and, like, they really hate the terrain if it's at all not flat for like a million miles. But you can then cut the terrain into them. It's nonsense. So I had this vision in my head from a very, very early age. No, from very early on in this build, even before I started the last build, that what I really wanted to do was have this ship kind of being dragged up to the surface of the world. Like, you've got to pretend here that you're underwater, right? You're below the surface. And I really like this idea of this giant ship being dragged by some mystical force up to the surface. And it would be on the way, and then you'd walk past it. And then when you get to the buffalo habitat, what you would see is the top half of the ship jutting out of the ground as it's been sort of pulled up by the bark. I don't know why the bark is doing this. Maybe this is... Okay, no, what this is all the... One... Okay, we can come up with a story. It's something about there was a pirate ship years and years and obviously centuries ago, and they were taken in the night by the bark. And then their ship obviously sank, and now, generations later, they have found the power of love and friendship and piracy to raise their ship. It's like the Black Pearl, basically, in a way. And now they've raised their ship, and they're back, and they're about to, you know, wreak havoc on the zoo, essentially. Something, there's something there. Anyways. Lots and lots and lots of rocks. Much fewer rocks this video than the next video. Last video, I promise. But I did need to kind of keep the aquatic, rocky, underwater sort of theme going. Basically, so that means lots and lots and lots of rocks. It is important to not cover it entirely in rock. If you use the rock tool on the terrain behind it, you kind of then want to, you know, just leave a little bit of it exposed. And yeah, so big shout out to whoever designed this ship. I will mention them later on in this video. I will give you their name. You can check it out on the Steam Workshop. It is an incredible piece of work. You know, this entire build was maybe 5 hours or something like that, which is not an exceptionally long time, but it is for me doing a YouTube video. You know, at the end of the day, I have a turnover time that I can't do much with. But this ship alone must be, I don't know how long it took, but I'd be surprised if it wasn't in the tens of hours. It's just not the kind of thing that's viable for me to ever build for this series, at least not at the moment, maybe one day. I'm not sure I could, don't get me wrong. And my past hesitance to not use workshop items means I wouldn't be able to do this in the past. I simply wouldn't be able to do this. I'm still trying to build the things where I feel like I can do my own unique spin on it and that it's a viable thing for me to build, but this ship is incredibly detailed and there's just no world it was going to happen in. So yeah, big shout out to them because it is it's very, very cool. Just ideal for what I wanted, really. And now this is the tricky part. The lighting. I knew I wanted it to have this bright shaft of light sort of descending from the ceiling. It should feel like moonlight was flooding in, all very dramatic, all very cinematic. I think cinematic is a good way to describe what I try to build in Planet Zero. I think that's often how I see it in my head. And obviously because it's watery above and you've kind of opened this gap in the earth, the water would be spilling around the edges. This is all just things I very much had in mind. This was a pain in the ass, however. It looked really good from the left, but I couldn't get it to look good from the right, as you'll see later on. First of all, we need some water effects on the ground, because obviously all this water is spilling in. And we need it to be colliding with the water I've already got in here. The boat is being lifted, so there's rippling and water around the boat as well, to kind of showcase that being dragged up towards the surface, as it would do, you know. Just light that up a little bit, make it nice and dramatic. Yeah, it was really easy. On the left-hand side, it looks fantastic. I'll show you, obviously, later on in the video. But in the on the right-hand side, you can kind of see the lights. They shine through because the lighting just doesn't catch the water in the same way. And it took so long to fix, and it's not even fixed. You're not allowed to look at it until you get to the left. And then it looks so good. The lighting in this game is amazing, but only on that specific angle. I also had this idea. This would be where the bark lives, essentially. She kind of emerges from this temple area on the right-hand side to, I don't know, survey her underwater kingdom or something. I don't know. I was just building the dumb ideas I had. There's not much more to it than that. It's just I saw in my head a little temple entrance with some torches going and like a little sacrificial bowl thing. People have in the past taken issue with the word temple. I want to clarify, a temple is basically just a place of worship. It might mean something more specific to you in general, but very generally speaking, a temple is a place of worship. That can obviously be a place for lovely, wholesome worship, as the vast majority of temples are. But you know, we're doing a horror theme, so temple in this case, not necessarily a lovely temple. No, there's nothing to take personally that, I promise. I'm not trying to have a pop. As a big fan of religion myself, even if I'm not religious, we're not getting into that in that video though. This is very much not on topic. My desk is so dusty. Anyways, yeah, so I spent a while on this just rearranging the water, rearranging the lights, just trying to make sure it was never going to look as good as I wanted on this right-hand side. But you can see there it looks pretty good. I wanted a little bit more light on the, how do I say this, other than the shaft? The pokey bit. What's the front? Is it the aft? No, the aft is the back. What's the front of the ship called? The pokey out bit. They stick like a mermaid under. I can't remember. That bit needed some light to seem like it was actually poking into the sky. Right, so fun bit. I decided to start this inside, which is very stupid in retrospect. And I did move outside pretty quickly, but I decided I wanted some sea life to sell this idea that we were underwater. I wanted some sea life swimming around the area, and obviously we don't have sea life in Planet Zoo. Now, other people have built sea life on the workshop, and I did consider it, but I figured this is very much the kind of thing I could have some fun building, and maybe do some stuff people haven't done before. Bloody, 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 blah. So we're going to make a few different sea life creatures. We've already got the jellyfish, of course, so we're going to make a big great white shark now. Then we're going to make a turtle, a sea turtle, and then we're going to make a giant octopus. Because, of course, you can't have a sunken pirate ship and not have a giant octopus. So, oh, excuse me. It looks bad now. I promise it comes together at the end. I don't really do this kind of thing at all. This is probably the first time I would suggest I've really tried to build something a little complex. I mean, not super complex, don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to big myself up here, but something a little complex using the art shapes in the game. It's just not something I do. It's just not something I attempt to do very often at all because I find it very tedious, generally speaking, and that's why I want to use the workshop every now and again a little bit more. But you know what? I quite enjoyed this, actually. I didn't want to do any more than this, but I enjoyed it for what it was. I had my little reference images up on the other side, and I was just trying to build a shark, basically, and, you know, use different items and stuff like that. There is a slight limitation to how much you can do, but it does look like an orca right now, by the way. I will be changing... The black is a little bit too dark. It's a little bit too black. I'll be making that into more of a steely grey-blue sort of colour. And then when you add in the all the other fins and stuff like that, it does become more sharky. I really wanted to put the gills on, but I just could not find a shape that would do it in an effective way. And I will say, so people are good, I'm sure this will eventually go in the workshop because they're part of the park at the end of the day, but it's important to realise that I build to fit my exhibit and I'm not trying to build to be impressive. That's why I don't put stuff on the workshop, because everything I build is very specifically made to fit my exhibit. And that means, like, the other side of this shark, for example, the right-hand side, that you'll never see, is a little bit of a disaster. Which, you know, makes me think it's not worthy putting on the workshop, even if it might be coincidentally helpful every now and again. But the other side is bad, it really is. Couldn't get, like, the shapes, per se. I was trying to build the mouth here. Again, same kind of deal. The mouth ends up looking okay from the side. I should see when we drew it in like that. There you go, look at that lovely stuff. Putting some little teeth there, using the full stop, the comma, I should say. Yeah, it's my shark. I'm quite proud of it. And we're going to have these, some of them are going to be underwater, but a lot of them are going to be flying around. Inverted commas. They're going to look like they're flying around. Obviously, we have to light it up a little bit. And no sticks or anything like that. Because it's beyond where the guest can see, because it's beyond the fence, I can assume a little bit more, I can be a little bit more forgiving in terms of how realistic things are, because if you can't see it, you know, maybe there's a rope hanging there or something like that, like a dark rope that you can't see, you know, that's a perfectly viable idea. So, bunch of sharks in them. Next up is the turtle. So, just again, just trying different shapes, blah blah blah, figuring things out. Like I said, it's not something I really do, so it's kind of a half an experiment to figure out what will work. But this has that kind of nice, sort of raised in the middle sort of shape you would get on a sea turtle. And I was trying to just scallop it a little bit at the back and the front, because it's a little bit rounder at the front and a little bit tighter at the back in terms of the shape of the shell. And then, of course, you've got the soft, delicious underbelly, much like myself. That dog needs to calm itself down. Needs to slow its roll, son. Anyways, turtle. Head. Turtle head. life. It's a little bit long there, but it'll come together. Again, just moving the shapes around bit by bit to kind of match the turtle shape, essentially. The one problem I had with this one is to try to get the scalloping on the back, because obviously it's, most turtles have a rather beautiful shape to the back, this kind of scalloped effect going along, and it was a difficult thing to include into our turtle. It's called a turtle, by the way, just so you're aware. These are the full stops for the eyes, very helpful. Put the head in just a little bit there. He was just kind of messing around, but I thought, you know what, because I'm going to say scalloped again. The edge of the turtle had like a scalloped edge. There's like this ring around the side of it. It's got like a little bit more texture to it. It's a little bit bumpier, a little bit tighter. It's, you know, it's surrounding the main hump, essentially. And using the faux rock like that was actually really effective. So I thought, oh, I'll try it underneath as well. Or like upside down and use that for the scalloping on the top. But that wasn't very effective. So I was just looking for things here. I forget if we do this, we take a circle and then you just drop it so just the front edge pokes out. It's relatively there. It's not exactly what I was looking for, but it's enough to show that there's a pattern going on there, you know, and that it's not just a blank turtle. Likewise, the turtle has, you know, as they often do, has like a dark greenish sort of, what's the word you'd use here? Spattled. What is the word I would use here? There's always a word I use here. Mottled, like a mottled pattern that I wanted to recreate on the actual skin as well. And that is our turtle. So in it goes. Again, some of them underwater, some of them flying. Just really trying to sell, you know, it doesn't matter that there's water there. This is, the whole area is underwater. It's magical water, okay? just roll with me on this. I just wanted it to look dramatic more than anything. That was all that mattered. It had to look dramatic and cool. And then one final creature, I wanted to build an octopus. I've been trying to keep all these relatively realistic. This one, I did the same for the head. I tried to make it look as head slash body as an octopus after all. I did base it on a real octopus. I was trying to get the right shapes in and stuff like that. But then in order to make the whole thing a little bit more dramatic, the tentacles are a little bit haywire, to say the least, as you'll see. But yeah, just trying to make this look relatively like an octopus. An octopi have really octopodes. I'm an octopodes kind of man. They have a really, and some people will argue with me on that. I just say, I don't care. they have a really weird head shape, actually, it must be said. I was just going to use a big ass ball, but that wasn't really a good idea. That is just meant to be, you know, the opening they have towards the, I think it's like the gills, essentially, towards the back of the head, just before the body and the tentacles start. Anyways, there you go. Now, it looks a bit daft there. What I thought, right, we'll put it in and then we'll go from there. And I just started to kind of weave these primitive tubes together because they stick onto each other and they naturally curve. And they're really cool for making these long winding tentacles. And I wanted it to be maybe it's hungry for delicious ghosts. Maybe it's a soldier for the bark or something like that. You know, when it's trying to grab this ship as it launches itself towards the surface. It's trying to hang onto it and sink it back down to depths so it and its ghostly master can feed upon its ancient denizens. Usual zoo stuff, you know? Oh, man. What am I going to do with myself? Anyways, so I got the idea that as well, the octopus is also moving because it's, you know, moving around trying to grab this ship. A little bit of sinking, a little bit of water. A little bit of water? Is that how we say water? How do you spell water if you're from the north? W-A-A. Wait, no. W-A-E? Water. Water. Yeah, W-A-E is how you spell water. Just see what. Water. Water. Anyways, that's the exit there. So the idea is, again, you're going to walk through the water again because this time you're leaving, essentially. You're breaking through the surface of the water back onto land, and that's where the lovely buffalo will be. The buffalo, I had an idea, because I kind of wanted it to be a little bit bark themed. It was going to be this sort of ancient, haunted, witchy swamp kind of thing. Kind of similar, I guess. The problem is it's similar to the church we did in the Halloween Zoo. That was very much the temptation. I am leaning quite heavily to this idea now that the exhibits are always super normal, and then we'll just do a crazy thing for the cryptids along the way. You know, kind of just mix and match like that. I might try to throw like a hint of the bark in there, but not go too crazy. I don't know. I'm gonna think about that over the next couple of days. I haven't started working on it yet. I thought I'd hang up some of the animals, well, just a turtle, really. And because it's closer to the guests, this time it has the rope, the string holding it up, the metal pole, whatever you want to call it. Again, just to emphasize that this is a zoo. You might be looking at something crazy, but the crazy thing is far away. When it's far away, the craziness can be justified. You can't necessarily see all the machinations that hold this thing together from a million miles away, but when you're up close and the turtle's right next to you, you need to be able to see the strings. Is my current thinking on how I'm going to do this kind of thing. Anyways, yeah, big shout out to Acreatus. This is, the coral is a funny one, because with the shark and stuff, I could kind of figure out how I'd make a shark. With this, I don't know if I would have ever, this is the faux rock step kind of thing, and he's kind of folded around many times to make this really cool coral texture. Stuff like that, I don't know if I would have figured out, really. It's just people being very creative and very talented. There's a difference between that and the ship. This is more like, I could have built the coral in theory, but I wouldn't know how to build the coral. And the ship, would I be good enough to put it together correctly? And also, do I have the time? Probably not. So it's kind of a different theme, but those are the two things I would typically want to use the workshop for, I suppose. Anyways, chucking some benches in there. Chucking some, you know, donation bins. Chucking some, even the ATM machines, again, just to kind of sell the fact that it's meant to be a real zoo from some bins there as well. You'll notice every now and again it lags. It jumped. You can't really tell because it's on like 1000% speed, but because the coral is so detailed, when you cross an object over with it, or you add it to an object or whatever, it kind of lags the game for a moment because it's like, whoa, 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 we're intersecting about 5,000 objects here. Can you just calm down? And I will not be calmed down. Anyways, that is it. Very exciting rock to look at whilst we finish this. So we'll hop in game. I'll give credit to those two people. They're up on my famed explorers board. And then we'll hop in and see how it all comes together. See you in a sec. Right then, let's go on a little explore. First of all, thank you to our sponsors. So it's Acreatist for the coral and Jure for the parrot ship. I believe Jure is a YouTuber, a very talented one. But big shout out to them. The parrot ship in particular, it's just not something I think I probably could ever have done, so I have to give a massive amount of credit because it really does tie the build together. The build would not really exist without the pirate ship, so I'm very, very thankful for that. That said, I have now got this kind of desire before the end of this wetlands pack to maybe build something a little crazy like that, to take an idea and just build a gigantic thing and really put all my focus into building this one giant object, hopefully something no one's done before. I don't know what it would be at this point in time, but I'm now kind of tempted. It would have to be the subject of a video, and I always get a little bit nervous about these non-animal videos. You know, they don't tend to be as popular, but we'll see. Anyways, the Cove of the Bark. We're going to go from the back. We're going to go through it again, just because, as I say, I've changed this whole area. So, you walk in. Oh, there's a thing there, but there is. You're walking through the water. You've been drowned. Now you're in. I think we could do with some, in the same way that we had the music for the cave, with the rake, maybe here we could have not spooky noises, but just underwater noises, you know, general, the sounds of the deep, this feeling that you're immersed under the water. That might be a good idea, actually. I might do that. Anyways, yeah, just mess around with the water effects. It doesn't really have to make sense. It just has to look cool, and I think it does. I think it comes together really well. It feels like a sunken cave, which is obviously very much what I was going for. When you're around the corner, you kind of get a glimpse of the shark and the water. And there we go. Bam. There's the... I really like it. I wasn't a big fan when I started to build it, but I tell you what, it's now that it's like grabbing onto the ship, and it's also, you can't really see it here, but it's kind of, yeah, grabbing onto the temple itself as well. All the legs are entirely different sizes. See my turtles there, shark up there. Not really much on this left-hand side, just more coral and general effects. There's the... it's all very dark, I admit, and you should watch this at night time to actually be able to see it, because there's light streaming through my bedroom window right now and I can't see a bloody thing. Yeah, there's our... I wanted to have like two of the creatures close. So there's our close-up shark, you know, just swimming past. And there's our close-up turtle doing its thing as well. Some jellyfish hanging around. Tall up there. There's our little sacrificial area or whatever it is. You know, maybe she makes... Oh God, I don't know. ATMs and benches and bins and stuff. So this part should feel... I really like this idea of it feeling a little like a zoo and feeling controlled and having the paths and the benches and everything else like that. And then having some, you know, batshit crazy stuff going on at the other side. I really like that combination. It's one I really want to work with as much as I can. I still haven't come up with a design philosophy for this, but we did it for the rig, so I'll fill those in pretty soon. And then, yeah, so I want you to see the light from here, because I just think this is beautiful. Look at that. Doesn't that look great? Lighting in this game is so good. It's so good. It's crazy. Just this mammoth amounts of moonlight streaming in. I feel like maybe I need to light up the area around it a little bit, you know. I think maybe it looks best about there. Yeah, I just really like how that looks. I think I probably do need to light this bit up a little bit more to make it realistic, I suppose, because it's quite, there's a lot of light. Let's try that out very quickly. So, well, let's grab, should have a light around here, shouldn't I? Yep, let's grab that. Say what? Not stadium light, I just need a area light. Just need to make sure these are sunk into the ground. Does that look better? I think that probably looks better. Either way, yeah, that is, I mean, there's not much else to show you, folks. That is the build, I suppose. I mean, it's only for this one room. It took bloody ages, but, you know, I think it was worth it. I think this is near enough exactly what I had in mind. You know, the ship being lifted up from the depths. You can see the little shark there and stuff like that. The Kraken grabbing at it, this sacrificial chamber, the light and water spilling in from the surface, the coral and the wetness. Everything is approximately what I wanted, so I'm pretty happy with it, even if it did take a while. And then you'll, you know, walk over here through the water. I'll just put some walls up in here and stuff like that, just kind of decorate this general area. And you'll walk around here, and you'll be in the buffalo habitat, which will sit right here. Now, I'm a little limited in space. I might bring in this path a little bit more to get some room, but this area here will be the buffalo habitat. It isn't massive. I'm at the very edge of what the map will allow at this point in time, so, and then we'll squeeze through there and go on to the rest of the zoo. The zoo is going to be gigantic. Yeah, that's about it. I'll show you the daytime. It doesn't really work at daytime, however, must be said, but I'll do it anyway. You see what I mean? Just kind of goes a little bit strange. It's very, very ineffective. You can see how different the lighting effects are. There clearly is like a universal value for lighting in this game. Different things are affected at completely different rates. I mean, look at the water. And then look at the ship. You know, it's a very different thing. Water and terrain seem to basically do their own thing. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. So let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Let me know if you've got any particular ideas, inspiration. If you're going to throw out inspiration or ideas you've got, you know, if you could throw me reference images in particular, that'd be fantastic. I've got a really cool idea for the capybara habitat and one other. I don't have anything great sticking in my mind for the buffalo. It might be a fairly chill habitat, just happens to have a giant ship in the middle. But even the viewing area and stuff like that, I'm open to suggestions. I'd like to start to tie it back in. We've done this bit. This has been like a heavily themed little section, right? I'd then like to tie it back into this here. So, you know, this rope fence and this kind of style of building here we're going to go back to. I do want it to feel like a themed zoo area, not just a hodgepodge of cryptid nonsense, which is very much where I'm leaning. Anyways, we will end it there. Thank you so much for joining me. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video and the build so far. We'll be back at some point in the coming week with the next episode. Yeah. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, myself, as always. Bye-bye. I just wanted to show you what the path looks like from inside the cryptid bit, okay? I think it looks really nice. That's all I've got, is like this tunnel of, maybe I want to glass this up. No, that's stupid. But this swathe of light cutting through that darkness is it's pretty cool. Alright, bye.